What's going on, guys? It's your boy Franklin. So Phillip Schofield is ITV presenter, well known across the UK, across Britain. It's been on TV forever, for donkey years. Now, a few days ago, he came out on TV and publicly declared to the nation that he is in fact gay. But what I find really devastating and shocking is the fact that this guy has been married for 27 years, and to spend nearly 3 decades with someone professing, you know, and proclaiming your love for them and all that stuff, it's really serious, okay? There's lots of emotional time and time-related investment into that relationship, okay? But what really caught my attention was, as I looked into the headlines and tweets and all that stuff, then I read an article where Phillip Schofield himself admitted that he in fact knew that, you know, he was gay before getting married 27 years ago. And I was like, wow. Like, you knew. The mainstream media, there is an agenda, you know, there's an agenda to, they constantly try to brainwash people on a daily basis because they're very powerful, they're well connected, they control numerous channels. And for most people, when we pick up our mobile devices, when you read and this, you realize that the news that you consume on your TV boxes and on the newspaper, on news apps and radio, you know, sometimes podcasts, numerous outlets that are controlled by the, you know, mega mainstream media, they constantly, you know, stick their narrative down our lungs, which affects the way people reason, which affects the way we behave, which affects the way we interact and stuff like that. Now, when this news broke, it was quickly followed by, oh, he's greatly supported by, you know, his wife and kids. And then one of the things that really took me aback, that, you know, really shocked me, is this whole thing about, Phillip, you're so brave. This whole congratulatory, you know, messages about, you're so brave, you're so, sorry. I am desperately trying to see where the bravery lies. So you came out in 2020 to tell the general public that you're gay. For me personally, big deal. Like, okay, good to know. Keep it moving. It's not like you've ended world poverty. It's not like you've basically tackled racism, or you've obliterated sexism, or you've basically dealt with the global war or conflict, or you've dealt with, you know, climate change. You've done something really, really intriguing and marvelous that people can be like, wow, this comes with a major wow factor. You came out publicly to let the nation know that you're in fact gay. And so we've got to then call you brave. I don't understand the bravery. I get it. Some might want to argue and say, oh, there was once upon a time when, of course, there was an era when, you know, people who were gay had to be, you know, in the down low, underground, because of the, you know, societal norm is for you to be heterosexual and stuff, and they might feel some type of way, and if you come out in the open, the repercussions were severe. You could lose your career, jobs, you could be ostracized from your immediate society. In severe circumstances, people do get, you know, killed or obliterated. I get that. I'm thoroughly aware. But this is 2020, right? Big deal. In fact, it's all enshrined into law. If you make homophobic comments, if you make homophobic slurs, just the same thing about if you make racist comments and stuff like that, you're more than likely going to get, you know, arrested, get prosecuted, and, you know, the law would deal with you appropriately, right? So they are basically a protected group, if you, you know, the LGBTQ group and all that stuff. So like I said, I personally don't have a problem with whatever sexual orientation floats your boat. But this dude married a woman for 27 years. That's nearly 3 decades. You must have looked at the woman dead in the eye, like I'm looking at the down the lens now. On numerous occasions, you must have told her you love her, how much you love her, how much you feel about her. You want to spend your twilight years with this woman. You want to, you know, grow old with her. You made babies with her. You got between her legs. you made sweet love to that woman nearly 3 decades. Now, basically, in a nutshell, I strongly believe that this, to me, is just extremely, this is a case of extreme selfishness, because all I see, and this is my own view, all I see is just a case of me. This reeks of narcissism. This reeks of unbelievable level of selfishness. This is just me. Phillip Schofield, me. 27 years of living a lie, and you know, and then the narrative. This is what I'm talking about. The mainstream media. The narrative they're selling. Oh, his wife and kids are very happy. You know, they've made her. But we've not exactly heard from the woman. Of course, some would argue, you know, she doesn't owe the public an explanation or whatnot. But I cannot begin to imagine the emotional roller coaster that woman is going through. You're telling me. Let's call a spade, okay? I'm a regular dude, right? Just think for a moment. I'm with my woman. We've been together for so long, right? This is a woman. Let's, you know, for the purposes of this demonstration, it's a happy relationship. You're living life together. You've had kids, and you're heavily, deeply, emotionally, and financially invested. Time, everything. Your life is in that marriage box. This is your partner. This is your wife. This is your husband. You're living together, right? And we make love. We do everything like couples do. And then 27 years down the line, I look at that woman dead in the eye and say, oh, I'm sorry, baby. You know, I knew before I married you. They said, according to the news, Phillip met her when she was an assistant on a TV. Was it? I've forgotten who she was working for. But she was like a camera crew or something, assistant, right? They met. They were both young and stuff. And then it started from there. But he said he knew. So basically, you had to leave a lie. Someone to argue, oh yeah, because of the pressures from the society. If I bump into a woman, I was talking about my woman, this woman, I was using myself as an example. Imagine me looking at a woman and then saying I'm gay after 27 years, and you expect that woman to just, everything to be normal and just support me because I'm now brave after wasting a time, after pissing on her emotional, financial, all of our investment in that marriage. And then I didn't come out and say, hey man, you know, I'm gay and I'm going public, so I'm gonna move on. Well, there's an allegation that's going around the web, basically, you know, I don't know how far that is true, saying Phillip Schofield was in fact having an affair with a younger, you know, gay dude who probably had a brief stint within the ITV. So, and then the relationship ended, or the affair ended acrimoniously, and then the younger dude threatened to go public with the information. So, I suspect this was a carefully crafted damage control by Phillip and his team, and perhaps the ITV themselves. You know, I like I said, it's been alleged, and it's the web. Twitter particularly is awash with that information. The photographs, you know, I'm not going to put the dude's photograph in my video, but even if that's not the case, you had 2 kids by this woman. So long and short is what the media is wanting us to believe and conform to is, oh yeah, accept this as normal. Just give him your support. Don't talk about it. Don't think outside the box. Don't get analytical about it. Don't ask questions. Be happy for him. It's about Phillip. And this is what I call mental conditioning. I don't care. Like I said at the start, you know, what your sexual orientation is. But is it fair to make a mockery of someone else's life, being in a relationship with someone for that long, and then you particularly said you knew? Big deal, man. It ticks me off, you know, like, big deal. If you're gay, be gay, man. Enjoy your life. Live your life. You dig? That's absolutely fine. For me, there's nothing spectacular about it. This is 2020. The world is moving, man. You know, that's great. Live your life. But the whole idea of somebody else's happiness, emotion has to be diminished and suppressed And the narrative of the media is, you know, it's about Phillip, or it's about the person, with anyone with a similar type of narrative. Oh, I'm happy for you. You're courageous. You're so brave. Where is the bravery that you're gay? I think it's utterly selfish. I think it's heavily one-sided. I feel the woman has been used. Somebody might argue, oh yeah, you know, I'm yet to see that human being, please. I try to keep it real. I'm yet to see that human being, that woman, that will be heavily invested in a relationship with you. And then you just casually come out like, hey man, I'm no longer sexually attracted to you because, you know, I'm gay. Even if you discovered you're gay last month, it's going to end up acrimoniously. But of course, you can imagine Phillip Schofield, you know, he's well connected. He's a well-known name and brand. You know, there'll be lawyers and all sorts of stuff in the background. And, you know, there'll of course be a time of transition, and you know, the woman will be settled monetarily and split the wealth and whatever. And then but you cannot tell me emotionally that she's not devastated. You cannot just tell me that your daughters are, because I'm telling you, man, there will be legal paperwork that have to be signed, gagging clauses. You can't do interview. You can't say this. To protect the Phillip Schofield brand, it has to be done. We're humans. You lay with a man, he gets between your leg. You make love to him. You build with him. You expect to grow old with that man, and then he comes out to say, "This is who I am. Be happy for me. I'm taking my bravery to the world." Anyway, what do you think? Let's keep the conversation going. Emancipate yourself from mental slavery. You know, there are two separate things. Anybody's within their rights, for the final time I'm going to say this, to live your life how you choose to. But I personally do not believe in the brainwash of the mainstream media. The whole thing, if you go and watch it on ITV, is so scripted. It looks so tedious. It looks so rehearsed. It looks so planned and orchestrated. It doesn't look so real. It looks to me like a well orchestrated, you know, damage control before somebody puts some, you know, an information out there that would devastate him and have a bad implication for the ITV network themselves. Let's quickly do this, go public, let the nation know, get the weight off your shoulder, buy into the sympathy, and then keep it going. It's the agenda. And if you dare to talk, some people don't even listen. They'll suggest that you're homophobic. But no, I think it's one-sided. I think it's utterly selfish. It's absolutely unbelievable. It's your boy, Phrankleen. Thank you for watching. Please, I'm particularly interested in keeping this conversation going. Okay, what do you think? How do you see this? Let's keep that conversation going on below. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace and love. Bye now. Hit on the subscribe button. Hit the like button. Show your love, man. And I'll see you soon. Bye.